Eh, macam bro, macam. Macam baik. Hello there world. I am a Madrib. Madrib.
Madrib. Madrib. Budak. Call me Boy Bancho. My Madrib name, bro. My Madrib name. But all of that was 2010 lah, bro. Hi, I'm Bancho, the Madrib. Madrib. I was viral in 2010, so how it all started was when I created the video How to be a Madrib Part 1. So in that video, I was reenacting how Madribs are, what they do, how they live their life, and then also I went viral for another video called How to Dance Like a Madrib. So to me, the word viral means when you become famous within a short time span. And then also, it will be embedded into people's memory of what that viral thing is, perhaps a video or somebody dancing and so on. When I was about 17, 18, I was interested in making videos. In Singapore, there was only Muna Hirzi. They were the main one. Then afterwards, I was watching a lot of YouTubers from other countries like Mai Choni, Peter Chow. Then I thought to myself, why isn't there a solo YouTuber in Singapore? So that's how I got the idea on, okay, why not I start it? And then it took about a week, then everything went viral. After that, I see my YouTube numbers going up. All this was happening and I actually didn't know what's happening. So it was quite unexpected for me. So I think my video went viral is because of my personality that I managed to bring up for my persona, being happy. It was also my luck where I was at the right place at the right time. There wasn't a lot of people doing YouTube. It was just me trying to do what I am interested in. Toughest part about making all these videos is not the idea, it's not the place, it's not the scripts, but it's the feel, you know? Because you need to have the feel to bring out your persona and your personality there. It's like if I go and say like, macam bro, macam, there's no feel towards it. So instead I would go like, macam bro, macam. That's the thing that is the hardest for me lah. Because without the feel, I can't really make videos back then. I managed to go on a Sura show called Kita Gerik, whereby I became a judge, you know. And over there, I managed to meet some of the Sura celebrity like Fizao, Nulaini, Najib Ali also. From my thought was, I'm just making a normal video. Then I managed to become a judge for a TV show. So that's quite interesting for me. Even up until now, some people do recognize me at times. They will come up to me and then they will ask me, are you Bancho? Then I ask them, how do you recognize me? Because normally I will post my sock pictures or how I walk on my Instagram. Then they say they saw it from there. Then they ask me, when are you going to make another video and so on? Then normally I will just say, when I can. I met my wife through Twitter. Then over time, it built into a relationship. And then I think back to myself, if I didn't start Bancho the Madrib, that whole chain wouldn't happen. I won't be able to know my wife, I won't even talk to her. That's the most memorable part about being Bancho the Madrib actually. So if you were wondering what I've been doing ever since I don't post videos anymore. Actually, I started posting videos when it was 2010, when I was in Poly. I was taking diploma in IT for about 3 years. So in 2013, I was enlisted as a police officer in HTA. So back then was the time where I start to slow down on making videos. When I ORD in about 2015, I start finding jobs. That's where I landed myself as an IT teacher. And I teach primary school kids from primary 1 to primary 6 how to use Microsoft Words, PowerPoints, programming. Some of my students was actually my fan. And actually they are of different age, primary 6, primary 5. And the best thing about it was, I tried to keep them interested in class. And I told them, if you do well, I'll give you a signature or you can take a photo with me as Bancho the Madrib. And amazingly, they did do well from those motivation. So I'm quite proud of that, that I'm actually able to help them focus in class and bring interest for them in school. After I finished my contract as an IT teacher, I actually went to become an IT engineer at NUH. And I worked my way up to become management side as a team lead. So my whole life is always about going up and going up. And then right now I'm still in the IT line actually as a system analyst. Other than that, I did illustration whereby I did for automobile, for motorbikes, for cars. And also I did videos for commercial use like some shops for a car washing shop and also for a food shop actually. So all this was my side hobby and that I can enjoy doing it aside from making all these videos. So if you give me a chance to repeat this whole thing again, I'll definitely do it because it's an experience that only comes once in a while. From it, you can create a history that becomes your own story that you take throughout your whole life. With all the opportunities that I had and also being famous, it does come with a lot of responsibility. A lot of people look up to me, so I have to portray myself as a good person. But it has to come from the heart. And the best thing you can do is to bring happiness and laughter towards them, and then they will follow you in those steps to bring a better life towards themselves. For the negative side, I did face my own race disliking what I did. So the negative stuff that they said are like, I'm wearing shades because I have one eye, or my eye are crossed, or like, I'm a Maghrib, I should go study, you know, shouldn't be making videos, should be using my time well. So it's really hurtful at that point of time. But then at the end of the day, words are still words. I just sit back, you know, and then told myself, hey, let's just make another video, because if I did follow their words, there won't be a next video. Hi, I'm Bancho, the Mat Rape. You're watching Viral Video Stars.